theorem 4, if A, B and C are the three events associated with a random experiment, then probability for P, A or B or C, that is equal to summation of the probabilities for A, B and C, then subtraction for the probability of A and B, B and C, A and C, and again summation of probability for A and B and C. So this is a theorem and we have to prove it. Let's prove it now. Let E is equal to B or C so that probability for A or B or C can be written as probability for A or E. Okay? Because in place of this B or C, we have taken E. Now, this becomes probability for A plus probability for E negative for probability for A and E. Now, using theorem, probability for E or F is equal to probability of E plus probability of F negative of probability of E and F. E and F. Okay. So, we are going to use this theorem occasionally here. Now, let this be number 1. Now, also PE, now probability of E, it can be written as probability for, now what E is, we are having B or C. Now, again applying the theorem on this part, we are having probability of B, probability of C, negative of probability of B and C. Second thing, now we are having now this term we have used here. Now about this term, now probability for A and E is equal to, we are going to use this term. Now this, we can write it this as probability for A, and now in place of E again we are going to write B or C. B or C. Now to this what we can write it? To this now we can write it. Now this is equal to probability for A and B union probability for A and C. Probability for A and B and probability for A and C. Now basically what we have used here, distributive property over union. This we have done in sets. Now to this part again, can we use this, because now this is a single term or this term. Okay, so even we can write it this one as, just don't, we can just omit this one. Okay, it can be like this only, like this. Okay, so can we use now this single part as E, this single part as F, then we can apply this theorem. Okay, so what we will be having now, we will be having this one as probability for A and B plus probability for A and C negative of probability for, now probability for A and B, negative of A and C. Is it clear? So this becomes A and B plus probability for A and C, negative of probability for A and B and C. Sorry, I am sorry, here it will be and. I am sorry, here it will be and. Okay. Now, so this is what, this is basically the third part. Okay. So, we have, what we have got it? We got what PE is and what probability for A and E is. So, now we are going to put these things in our equation number 1 now. Substituting value of 2 and 3 in equation 1, we get. Now, equation 1 is which one? This is the equation 1. So, we are having probability for A or B or C is equal to, now first of all, probability for A as it is, plus probability for E. Now this is the second part, okay, plus, now this I am taking in a separate bracket and with a separate ink. Now we are having, in place of this one, P, probability for E, so we are having probability of B plus probability of C, negative of probability of B and C. So this is what, this is only for this part. Now for this one, minus for this one, and this is which one? This is the third one. Okay, so negative of, this is negative, now negative of A and B, A and C, then again negative of probability for A and B and C. So this is the basic three different terms, PA, this one, as it is, this one. For PE, this one, this whole thing, this one. Let it be with a separate ink, this one. And then this whole thing, this one, with whole this thing, this one. Is it clear? So now what we are having, now this becomes probability of A plus probability for B plus probability for C. This is negative, again this is negative for these two terms now, okay. So negative of, negative of, negative of, positive for A and B and C. Hence, A or B or C is equal to probability of summation for A, B and C probabilities, negative of positive of probability for A and B and C. So this we have proved. Now we are going to solve some questions based on these theorems.